Hi, good afternoon. I'm here with Maddalena Ilario. She's a senior researcher at the Department of Public Health of Federico II University and the coordinator of Campania Reference Site of the European Innovation Partnership on Active Energy Aging. We discuss today with her about ProEmpower solution that is a solution that come from an European funded project. Is a pre-commercial procurement in which the two vendors developed two solution that are very similar for the early diagnosis and management of diabetes type 2 that are aimed to support them in their daily life and improve their empowerment and self-management. The main objectives of this interview will be to understand with Maddalena Ilario the method that they used to define the functional and non-functional requirements of the solution and the results that they obtained during the pilot that they implemented in their hospital. So please, Maddalena, I don't know if you prefer to be directly interviewed or you want to introduce yourself and the project, and then we will start.
Okay, my name is Maddalena Ilario and I am endocrinologist by training, and I have been involved in digital transformation of health and care in the partnership, European Partnership for Active and Healthy Aging for the past 8, 9 years. And we have been making an effort to build a multidisciplinary and inter-stakeholder ecosystem that is making an effort to implement innovative solutions to improve outcomes for patients, to improve work for professionals, and also to stimulate sustainable growth. So, Enzo, we can proceed with the interview.
Okay. Returning on ProEmpower, how long did you take for the implementation of the solution? How do you what are what were the phases that you addressed during the process?
Actually, this research and development process took 40 months for full completion. There were two preparatory steps and three phases. The first phase was the open market consultations that was focused on the workshops organized by the procurers in the regions. And this was dedicated to the consultation with vendors to inform them about technical specifications and to set realistic objectives for this procurement that still were innovative. Then we had the call for tenders that was an international tender launched on the project website and on the official journal of the EU. And then we have the three PCP phases. The first one focusing on the concept design, on the architecture of the solution, and on the technical specifications. The phase two is focused on the development of the prototype system, and third phase is the development and testing of the pilot system.
Yes, thank you. What are the key steps that were undertaken?
The entire approach is user-centered. So around the needs expressed by users, that in this case are represented by patients, professionals, and caregivers, informal caregivers, there was a co-design process that was very important to start an iterative development of the use cases and the service process models. And this was enabled by training activities that were required to support change management in each country or region. Indeed, change management activities are pivotal to ensure the adoption and integration in current clinical practice of the new service. And this information were used to specify the functional and non-functional legal and regulatory requirements to tailor to the solutions to these use cases and service process models. So the use case development included the identification of users for of the system that I mentioned a while ago, a second ago, the creation of a user profile for each category, the patient, the informal caregiver, and the professional, to identify all the different goals that were characterized by each user and create a use case for each goal.
Okay, so, but there is also an implementation phase, or it is only a co-design process. Can you specify what are the next steps? Then you implemented a co-design process to identify the use cases. And then what happened?
Then there is the pilot phase. The pilot phase is the phase where you test feasibility, effectiveness, usability of the solution, the pilot solutions. And this is important with the scope of integrating this solution with the current care pathways. These pilot studies have been all designed to evaluate the outcomes that were generated by the new product directly and indirectly. And among these outcomes, we have the behavioral changes, such as change in smoking habits, improved physical activity, meals, and adherence to medications. Number of steps, that is an indicator of indirect indicator of improved physical activity. Then there are some outcomes related to clinical and quality of life, like glycated hemoglobin, weight, blood pressure, lipids in the blood, cholesterol levels, and quality of life. And then there are elements related to satisfaction, self-management, and usability.
So, what are the strengths and the weakness of the implementation process that you described?
Actually, in terms of elicitation of the requirements, the strength has been the early involvement of users, intending by users, both patients and health professionals. And this was important because they could express their opinion on the functional requirements, on the user-friendliness of the interfaces, and this was collected through a dedicated questionnaire. There are also some questions that are open because there are creative inputs that should not be lost in the process, and it can improve the adherence of the patients to the solutions. And the users are, as we say, diabetic patients especially, and also informal carers that can help sometimes the patients with the day-to-day management of their disease.
So, is there also a work plan that can be included as a reference? There are any documentation about the approach that you adopt in the development of the solution?
Yes, we have been making an effort to piece together our approach in two papers, and actually the work was also presented at the conference, international conference, ICT4AWE 2019, and the references are available on two international peer review journals. One is focused on the description of the experience, and another one, the specifications for value-based pre-commercial procurement emerging from ProEmpower experience.
Thank you, but please, can you clarify what are concretely the strengths and weakness of the solution that comes from the project?
Actually, the effort in the project have been aimed at providing a one-stop shop to the patient so that he could take advantage of an integrated platform for the different tools that could facilitate management of his self-management, self-monitoring, and also the conversation and dialogue with professionals. And so this is very important, although some interoperability features could still be improved, especially towards the GPs that will be anyways involved in the delivery of the care, although at different levels, at the primary care level in the current organization of the regional health system.
Okay, and what are the stakeholders needed to be involved? And what are the rules and the activities that they implemented during during the entire project?
Actually, as it has been mentioned several times during the interview, the stakeholders required are patients, informal caregivers, and health professionals. Health professional means general practitioners, diabetologists, and nurses. We also made an effort to try to involve, since early stages of project design, policymakers and decision makers. But as when we started the ProEmpower, it was our first PCP. There was little awareness about the impact and the potential of PCPs to benefit the service provision by healthcare system. So this is an aspect that can be seriously improved by a joint international effort involving national and international levels towards regional policymakers and decision makers.
Okay, thank you. As you said, after a co-design process that is articulated in three phases, you tested in the real setting two solutions. Can you please explain what were the main outcomes of implementing the mHealth solutions?
Actually, the identification of the use cases and the process models have been two of the most important outputs that represent a framework that can be replicated also for other chronic diseases. These are two very important and valuable outcomes of the solution. There was also an increased awareness among the three different stakeholders of the need to collaborate since early stages of planning and project design. This is sometimes a difficult achievement, but being involved together in a European project is an added value that can be maintained and used also for day-to-day activities.
Okay, what is the status of the solution in your setting?
During phase one, there have been some evaluations of the technical, economical, and organizational feasibility to implement in current service the provision of these digital solutions. And the solution, the two, both solutions have been tested by 200 end users for each solution. Now the issue is to establish the tariffs and the reimbursement approach to ensure that this solution can be provided beyond the duration of the project.
Thank you, Maddalena. So, as you said, there is something that could be still be improved. And what is your future plan for exploiting this mHealth solution?
Actually, the current pandemic has been an unexpected enabler to implement telemedicine worldwide, and our hospital has been also activating telemedicine procedures that were supported by administrative and clinical assistance procedures. These procedures also took advantage of dedicated IT tools, including Pro Empower, and this was already started in March 2020. We hope that further evolutions of economic nature concerning reimbursement will subsequently be activated after, we hope we are approaching the end of the pandemic. So we will be able to focus on how to ensure that these services integrate face-to-face service provision to improve health outcomes in a normal service period.
Thank you, Maddalena. Thank you very much for your contribution to the discussion. I wish you a nice evening. Thank you again for your kind interview.
Thank you. We look forward to engaging in dialogue with suppliers in a PPI project. Bye, Enzo.
Bye-bye.